ISUPK.
All I'm going to tell you, man, if you want to stay plugged in and tuned in, make sure you subscribe to ISUPK on YouTube. A lot of powerful information will be coming out this summer, and you want to stay tuned in. The minute they drop it, it's coming right to you, baby, as soon as you subscribe. So make sure you handle that business and subscribe to ISUPK.
And then you got to have motherfuckers heckling you. You know what it feels like to stand in front of my daughters, and they looking at this shit.
Take your time.
They looking at this shit on the internet. And gotta hear motherfuckers talking about this nigga Planet Rock Bam's mic. Or better yet, y'all left me out there. Y'all threw me out there like an informant. I done bled for y'all niggas. I done went to jail for homicides. Multiple homicides. Not just me. Alibaba. Molested. Kip went to jail for homicides. Eric in there, right? It's so many of us that went to jail for homicides behind this shit. And most of us been touched by Bam. The majority of Bronx River projects been touched by Bam. Yeah, he did good works. But when you sit back and you analyze this shit, how good was your fucking work? How good was it really?
Exactly.
You created a cesspool.
Yes.
Peace, unity, knowledge, having fun, song, dance, everything to lure everybody in. And when the dark came, in them dark rooms, in them closets, there's a lot of skeletons. Right. You done hurt more motherfuckers than you done saved.
Right.
He said he was going to do things for the youth, and he was going to apologize to everybody else. I forgave Bam. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, I want people to understand something. I got a lot of anger towards Bam, but I still love him like a father to me. So I'm not going to slander him, even though he did some fucked up shit. I love that man. I hate what he's going through. I love that man. But what I will say is, I'm heartbroken, man.
Take your time.
I'm heartbroken because my brothers know, and I had a conversation with them. I told them, I said, you know what? There's brothers out there in Zulu Nation that don't know me. They don't know how I get down. And for you to leave it like that, and they feel like I love Bam. Everybody feels like Bam is a hero. Somewhat, I felt like he was a hero to me. So for y'all to leave it like that, and some of the new Zulus that don't know me, you see me on the street, and I have to deal with you because you feel like I'm an agent. Y'all left me out there to be a fucking agent. And for me to have to hurt one of them because they love him with some sucker shit. And I had this conversation with one of the brothers and I told him like, yo, this is what you're doing. Brother, don't put me involved. How you gonna tell me not to put you involved when you called the meeting? You begged me to take the video down, and I took the video down because y'all wanted to save the Zulu Warriors. I wanted to save the Zulu Warriors. You did good work with the Zulu Warriors. Fed a lot of people. I understand these brothers got love for Bam. I had love for Bam too. What made me lose my respect for Bam at this point in time, after what you did to me, you left the whole Zulu Nation to feel the wrath of what the fuck you did. And you ran like a fucking coward and won't step up to the plate and own up to your shit. I even called out and told them, listen, we can come in the public, apologize, even apologize to the other people you hurt, and go get some help together. That's how much love I had for that man. That man was like a father to me. People want to know why, well, you know, how you felt so comfortable. I got answers for y'all. To be around Bam, for one, Bam wasn't the first person to molest me. Bam was like the fifth person to molest me. So when he got to me, I was already broken in. You understand? I was already broken in. That's why I was already confused, fucked up. So in one way, you know, in some ways, Bam was still like a hero to me. I know people gonna say, yo, you know, whatever y'all got to say, whatever questions you have, I can answer. Bottom line to it is, Bam should have stepped up and he should have saved the Zulu Nation and kept everybody from going through the scrutiny. But one thing I did learn from this situation is who the fuck is my family and who ain't. Some of those dudes that's still on the council, that's still sitting there, they're covering up for a pedophile. And that's all I can say. Some of these brothers, you're covering up for a pedophile. Y'all know what he did. And then y'all put out a video saying that, you know, y'all gotta look into it. What the fuck is there to look into? He admitted to it already. What is there to look into? So if you could cover up for a pedophile for a couple of dollars or because of your feelings, then you deserve, y'all deserve to die with him. You deserve to die with him.
That's right. That's
real shit.
You got something you wanna ask me?
I have a question. You know, some people say, why so long to come out? Why would you take so long to come out? This is, I know you heard that many times. Why did you take so long to come out?
Well, for one, if anybody out there can answer this question, how do you tell somebody that a man touched you? How do you tell somebody that a man put his mouth on your private part? How do you tell somebody that a man, it's like the thoughts of it, to even speak it out of my mouth? How do you say that? And then when you somebody that got a reputation like me, I'm strong in these streets, and then you gotta have motherfuckers heckling you. You know what it feels like to stand in front of my daughters and they looking at this shit.
Take your time.
Right, yeah.
They looking at this shit on the internet. And got it here. Motherfuckers talking about this nigga Planet Rock Bam's mic. Or better yet, y'all left me out there. Y'all threw me out there like an informant. I done bled for y'all niggas. I done went to jail for homicides. Multiple homicides. Not just me. Alibaba molested. Kip went to jail for homicides. Eric in there, right? It's so many of us that went to jail for homicides behind this shit. And most of us been touched by Bam. The majority of Bronx River Project's been touched by Bam. Yeah, he did good work. But when you sit back and you analyze this shit, how good was your fucking work? How good was it really?
Exactly.
You created a cesspool.
Yes.
Peace, unity, knowledge, having fun, song, dance, everything to lure everybody in. And when the dark came, in them dark rooms, in them closets, there's a lot of skeletons. Yes. You done hurt more motherfuckers than you done saved.
Right.
But everybody feels sorry for the pedophile. How?
Can't do it.
Right. How you feel sorry for the pedophile? How y'all crying over Bam like Pepsi? I heard you was boo-hoo crying because Bam had to step down yesterday. But you ain't crying for me. You ain't crying for my kids.
Right.
You ain't crying for my moms that got to listen to this.
Yes.
My mom's got to fuck. She got to feel this. She got to feel the rap because this went on with hubby and my mother.
Exactly.
But you crying, bitch? Seriously? Muhammad. Fuck it. I'm calling names again. I went through hell when Bronx River opened. Hell. You blame B.O. for fucking up my life. B.O. ain't fucked my life up. You know what happened? You got shot. And when you got shot, I went to war with my whole projects as a baby. Y'all left me for dead. Bronx River ran y'all out the project. left me for dead, and that's when I had to pick up steel and learn how to defend myself like a man. And that's when I turned into a savage over you, Muhammad, not P.O. Y'all left me, never came back to fight the battle. And the last homicide that I went to jail with was over the same nigga that shot you. But you gonna tell me that you can't clear my name?
Right.
Wow.
And you my brother?
Right.
I don't even have nothing else to say. Right, Poppy, I'm disgusted.
Poppy, if I can briefly ask you, you mentioned your mother and you mentioned your daughter. Now, we all realize that the victim is the first casualty, but then it's our women that have to pick up the pieces. Even Brother Savage said in his relationship, for 17 years, he couldn't hold hands. And if I can recount what you stated before, the intimacy, women were questioning, hey, how come you're not responding? They didn't know you were dealing through crap that you dealt with this man violating you that early. So can you speak to what are the women's role for helping brothers that are trying to heal through this?
You know what? The only thing I can say to the women is take more responsibility as being mothers. Because some of y'all get so caught up on who y'all sleeping with. Whatever. Some women, like my mom's had six kids, but it goes deeper than that. I'm gonna let you in on a family secret. In my mom's family, my mom's grew up with her stepfather was raping her sisters. And they got pissed off when I posted it up on Facebook, but I don't care. It is what it is. You know, so she came from an abusive house and had to break free as a young age. Got with my father, who was a dope fiend. You know, I was already messed up behind my pops not being there, mad at the world, halfway hating my moms. My moms wasn't a bad mom. She was a distracted mom. You know?
Exactly.
And at the end of the day, mothers have to talk to their kids. A lot of women out here, the biggest problem with your women is your anger. And y'all take it out on your sons, especially if y'all love the father and he ain't there. The son becomes that enemy. And this is the problem with the women. You know, see, another thing I want to touch on too, when somebody says, mom, dad, or society, he touched me, you do not put that kid on the hot seat. You put that pedophile on the hot seat. Lord Sharif stepped forward, and when he stepped forward, he got put on the hot seat. People picked the wrong timing. When you put people or victims on a hot seat, and everybody else, if I had to do this all over again, I don't know if I could do it all over again because of my kids. You see what I'm saying? So when you put somebody on a hot seat like that, you gotta understand something. You make them children say, I'm not going through that.
Right.
Some of the hecklers on all over the internet, when you read those comments, if a kid had to read that, how the hell do you expect them to come forward? I firmly believe some of y'all dudes are pedophiles and y'all trying to chase them kids back in the hiding. They're not gonna come forward. And the people need to see that y'all out here, that we out here, we got them. I got you. Believe me, I got you. I got the children.
Knowing what you've been through, and you say you have children now, what do you do to protect your children from what happened to you?
I failed my children. I went to jail. Murder cases, 94. Left my son out here. My son that I left out here. Somehow he got molested. Now to this day, he got titties. He a woman now. Not even in my life. Because somebody molested him. And I never got to catch up to whoever molested him. You know, so the story runs deep. Somewhere at some point, everybody got to take a stand. You don't cover up for pedophiles. Pepsi, Ahmed, everybody else that was at that meeting, how the hell you gonna run the head? How you gonna be the head of the Zulu Nation when you still covering up for a pedophile? How? How? So you mean to tell me if I come through the door with a couple of million, I could fuck a few little kids too? Is that how it works? Somewhere down the line, you know, Zulu Nation got secrets. This something I take to my grave. But child molestation is not one of them.
I have training in nursing. There was a case in 1964 that happened here called the Genovese effect. Anyone who studies psychology, they know a person who was brutally murdered and tons of witnesses heard it, they saw it, but nobody called. All of these abuses taking place, could this be a situation where people just thinking, oh, someone else is going to report it, someone else is going to take action? And if that still exists among us, isn't that an indictment on us as a community? Because you even asked your first recording. You knew I was in that room. How come you didn't come and take me out of that room? So are we just looking at our kids being brutalized and taken advantage of and not man enough to stand up and defend them? Is that part of what we collectively own because of this tragedy?
You know what? I can't even answer that question. I'm just too emotional. I can't even think straight right now. What I do want to say is, though, once again, I would have took this secret to my grave. Because this is just some shit you don't tell somebody. Like, I got homies, but my wife, my family, like, yo, you never told me this. How the fuck could I?
How could you? Right, exactly.
But I kept hearing, you know, stories. Whispers, Bam doing this, Bam doing that. Bam got locked up in Brazil. Bam got stabbed. I rushed to the hospital. What happened? Somebody tried to rob him, get to the hospital. Saladin, once again, Poppy, get involved in this, you're going to hell. In the pit of my stomach, I already knew what time it is. So, make a long story short, then you come to find out he giving a young man head with his finger in his rectum, and he wakes up and loses it and stabs Ahmed, he stabs Ahmed, and he stabs Ben. There's over 100 people loaded up with guns at the hospital. Why would you lie about being stabbed if you didn't do nothing to that young boy? Ahmed, why would you lie about it? Don't call y'all names? Why wouldn't I call y'all names? Y'all covering up for pedophiles. Why wouldn't I call your name? Mm. Why wouldn't I? How the fuck do y'all sleep at night?
Right.
How? On some real shit, Ahmed? One day you said to me, I don't know if you remember it. Well, I saw B.O. with his dick in Bam's mouth. But I thought you said you ain't never seen that. You don't remember saying that to me? And you said that to me about my hero? I don't know why, maybe I had some issues. But if you ain't seen nothing, how could you say that about him? Plenty of times I was in that room, you was in the next room. Everybody in the world knew what was going on. If you go to Bronx River or you talk to anybody in the Bronx about Ben, and you ask them about the Zulu Nation, they say, he's like Freddy Krueger. We ain't playing with that boy lover. The verdict is in. We gonna stop with the bullshit, with the alleged bullshit. Let's stop it, man. Ben been the boogeyman. We ain't waiting for him to step forward no more. The only thing for you to step forward to do is to come get help. And if you're willing to step forward and come get help, I stand beside you still. And don't give a fuck about what nobody got to say. See, another thing I want to put on blast too, with y'all conniving asses, I noticed how y'all start trying to move my age up, forgetting that I was in jail at 18 for murders. Can't change that. Trying to move me up like I was a grown man messing with him. Nah. Y'all tried to have Saladin say that Bee Stinger molested a 4-year-old girl 3 days ago. Tried to have him call in and call Star. Call Star, ask Star about it. Called him on the phone to put those kind of allegations on Bee Stinger. What kind of shit is that? So y'all willing to go that far? To free Ben? For what? So he could go back to Brazil and get locked up again for playing with another little boy? This is just recent shit. So it's okay for Bam to play with as many little boys as he wants to. Not on my watch, I'd rather die.
Right.
And one thing I will say, I expect to see some of y'all out here. I'm not running. I ain't going nowhere. It is what it is.
What I'd like to first say is we need to give Poppy and all of them a round of applause. To even give his story, to face the backlash. I saw his kids. I don't know if y'all friends with him on Facebook. I am. And I saw his two girls. He got two beautiful girls. And to see him to still raise them kids up through the hell that he been through. Remember, it ain't just Bambada that he was a victim. He was a victim to a bunch. And for him to be able to raise a family up, I think is to be commendable.
That's right.
The other thing I think King Simon said, and what I've heard other people say, is the whole alleged term. I think we're way past that.
Yeah.
We should stop saying alleged. He's a pedophile. And also something that's being said, which I hear all the time, which is a culture. The culture is not just hip-hop. The culture exists from the Roman Catholic Church,
from Christianity.
Hip-hop is no different than the Roman Catholic Church.
That's right.
And that's what we're finding out.
Right.
Because they look at Bambada as if he's the father of hip-hop. And that was built the same way Christianity was built, child molestation.
Right.
And we have to face that reality. And then they mentioned how Bambada, they said Bambada is stepping down now. We have to realize that, and I'll use this analogy. When Mike Brown got killed in St. Louis, right? And then they didn't charge the cop for the crime. And then they investigated the whole Ferguson. And they found out from the governor all the way down to the clerk that it was corrupt. And so the only way to fix that corruption is to do what? To tear the whole thing down.
All the way down.
And start all over.
Yes, sir.
That's the Zulu Nation.
Right.
The Zulu Nation has to be tore all the way down because damn near like Johnny Come Late. If Poppy don't say nothing, if Savage don't say nothing, they still molesting little boys.
Right. Yeah,
they still doing it. The only reason they saying something is because the pressure is coming up so bad. The pressure is coming up so much to where they can't hide it. So when KRS-One say, I don't give a fuck what Bambada did. Because he cares about hip-hop so much, I would love what black people have to stop doing it, and what we all get caught up in is idolizing men. And women, for that matter. We turn people into idols, and they become idolized so much that when you find out they're guilty, you're easy to let it slide. So we'll let the likes of R. Kelly slide.
Right.
We'll let Prince slide. Prince died, and it's like we got to play Purple Rain all damn day. When doves cry all day. Meanwhile, he was a booty bandit.
Right.
He was the number one pusher of homosexuality with them high heel shoes with that pruning of his hair, with that feminine vibe. He turned Tevin Campbell into a faggot.
Right.
Tevin Campbell was straight until he got with Prince.
Right.
And then now you look at Bambada. I was doing some research last night, and I seen the Jungle Brothers came up. Anybody seen that cat from the Jungle Brothers?
Yes, sir.
Baby Bam.
The cat from the Jungle Brothers is now a cross-dresser. You know what his name is? Baby Bam.
Damn.
And he rolled with him too. So now you see all of the trickle of sis. His name is Baby Bam. He probably was Baby Bam because that was Bam's baby.
Right.
And I don't mean baby like you raised somebody up like a child. I mean a sex partner.
Right.
And so what we have to start realizing is that a lot of these things that, like, if we could tear this down, we should be willing to tear anything down that's destroying the black community.
Right.
That's why Israelite School UPK, we crush the Christian church.
Right.
We crush all of these different philosophies that's tearing us down.
Right.
Because what's more important? Is hip-hop more important than Poppy?
No.
The culture more important than the man, than the woman? And someone has to care because nobody does.
Right.
That's why a brother like Irritated Genie, he has a strict black pride movement. We have our movement. Now, it may seem like we're different. And in some cases we are, but we can sure unite for this hit.
Absolutely.
We can come together and say, I don't like my children being molested.
That's
he
right.
said he don't like that
right.
either.
Right.
He don't like men being faggots.
That's
I
right.
don't either.
Right.
He said he don't like women being lesbians.
Right.
I don't either.
Right.
What can we do about
right.
that?
Right.
And we decided to come together and do an event. Do a lecture where we can speak on the atrocities, we can speak on the history, where this culture comes from,
right.
and then provide solutions to fix it.
Right.
Which is the most important thing on the face of the planet.
That's right.
Because brothers like this don't exist everywhere.
That's right.
This brother's a rare breed.
Yes, sir.
I mean by rare breed, for every Poppy, there's a million more that won't say nothing.
Exactly.
Right. Right.
Because we're taught that they got that phrase, children should be seen and not heard.
Right.
Or don't ask, don't tell. And then when you run and tell your parents because they love that uncle more than they love you,
that's right.
or they love their boyfriend right. more than they love you, you say, I've been molested. No, you wasn't.
Right.
You're lying. And then he shuts up. Stop asking the question, why does it take so long?
Exactly.
Right.
That question need to get thrown out the water. Yes. It's damn near insensitive
right.
to that brother or sister to ask that question because you can't put a price or you can't put a time frame on when somebody can speak.
That's right.
You understand?
Right.
So when they willing to speak and tell their story and you find out that it's true, let them let it all down and then let justice reign.
Right.
Let everybody get tore right. down. So,
Captain Desire, man, I just have to, our men, especially in the inner city, have always come together.
out of the need for protection, out of the need to defend themselves against a larger society, has always hated and targeted us. They formed the Black Spades. They formed the Zulu Nation. They formed Casanova all over, the Latin Kings. So these are now their gangs, but these are organizations that were formed for us to defend ourselves. Now, I do understand that there have been corrupt individuals in there. Do we just throw the whole organization away? And lastly, this brother still expressed a loyalty. He said if he got help, he would love everybody today. Now, that's amazing to have been a victim of him, but still have a loyalty to that organization. So it's bigger than a man. If he is wrong, he needs to be condemned. But do we throw all of our organizations away, or can we not just get them recouped?
That's why I called him a superhero, because I don't know if I'd have been that strong. Mm-hmm. That's why I called him the superhero. Mm-hmm. The fact that he can say I can forgive him if he gets the help proves just how strong his brother is, because I don't know if I'm that strong. Now, when it comes to organizations, you mentioned the different gangs and stuff like that. There was a brother, I believe, by the name of Supernova Slime. That's his name.
Yeah.
Now, that brother, he was a higher-ranking man in a gang. And he even said how in that gang they was doing molestation. They was doing homosexual acts. So when you ask, can a organization stand? Any organization should stand as long as it's not corrupt. If you're doing anything that tears down the Black household, why should you exist? It should not exist. So we gotta, that's why I said we gotta stop falling in love with the name or falling in love with the organization. We gotta fall in love with their principles.
Right.
We gotta fall in love with their ideologies, with their doctrines. And if their doctrines fix the Black household, then by all means we should be for it. But if their doctrine destroys the man, destroys the woman, destroys that child, how can we let it exist? It's like they buy a playground, but they rape it. Like they said, all that peace, love that Zulu was doing, but then in the background they bang a little boy.
Right.
Bring a little girl, so the hell, fuck the peace,
right?
Fuck the love, fuck all that movement and soul stuff, fuck all of that. That shit got to be torn to the ground.
Right. That's right.
And then let something rise up, because we shouldn't be afraid to tear down corruption.
Right.
Because what happens is, the reason why we don't want to tear it down is because it's been built. It's been built for 30 years, so it's like you're going to throw 30 years away, but it's been 30 years of a lie.
Right.
So when does truth take precedence?
Right.
And that's what Black folk need. They need the truth.
Let me say something real quick. Another thing I wanted to touch on too, stop making everything a fucking conspiracy. Van Bonner ain't got nothing to do with Bill Cosby. And that's the reality of it. Anybody that's been in the hood, that did any investigation, had any talk, that know what time it is already. Everything ain't a conspiracy. Right. You do not see Van on the 12 o'clock, 10 o'clock news. When that cracker come get you, they gonna smear you everywhere. They not touching this shit. They want it to continue. Use your fucking common sense.
Right.
Appreciate all the brothers and sisters coming out here. This means a lot. First thing I want to say is that it's inappropriate, and all of us should be able to understand this, to call somebody and say the words Africa and the word Bambaataa in the same breath for somebody that's accused of molesting children. From now on, it's Kevin Donovan.
No, that's bullshit. That's not his name. His name is Lance Taylor. I don't know where the Kevin Donovan came from. His name
is Lance Taylor.
And you know what? But then again, you see, you got to dig into that too. Why he keep changing his name?
Let me do this. Whatever it is, from this point forward, let's not put our identity as Black people in association with this behavior. I want to say, I first, in 1988, I had a sister sit down. I was 15 years old. She told me that she was molested. When I heard that story, I said, something's got to be done about that. It opened me up, and since that time, I probably done heard 100 to 200 to 300 stories from sisters, and then in the last 15 years, probably the same amount from Black men who have been sexually abused, who had nobody to tell. Many of those sisters that told their mother, and they went to their mothers, and their mothers blamed them for it. And the reality of the situation is that we gotta come to grips with this Black man.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm and blues, call this guitar smoke. rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword.
And they become idolized so much that when you find out they're guilty, you're easy to let it slide. So we'll let the likes of R. Kelly slide.
Right.
We'll let Prince slide. Prince died, and it's like we got to play Purple Rain all damn day. When doves cry all day. But meanwhile, he was a booty bandit.
Right.
He was the number one pusher of homosexuality with them high-heel shoes on. With that pruning of his hair, with that feminine vibe, he turned Tevin Campbell into a faggot.
Right.
Tevin Campbell was straight until he got with Prince.
Right.
And then now you look at Bambaataa. I was doing some research last night, and I seen the Jungle Brothers came up. Anybody seen that cat from the Jungle Brothers?
Yes, sir.
Baby Bam.
The cat from the Jungle Brothers is now a cross-dresser. You know what his name is? Baby Bam.
Damn.
And he rolled with him too. So now you see all of the trickle of, his name is Baby Bam. He probably was Baby Bam because that was Bam's baby.
Right.
And I don't mean baby like you raise somebody up like a child. I mean a sex partner.
Right.
And so what we have to start realizing is that a lot of these things that, like, if we could tear this down, we should be willing to tear anything down that's right. Destroying the black community.
Right.
That's why Israelite School UBK, we crush the Christian church.
Right.
We crush all of these different philosophies that's tearing us down.
Right.
Because what's more important? Is hip-hop more important than poppy?
No.
Right.
Is the culture more important than the man, than the woman? And someone has to care because nobody does.
Right.
That's why a brother like Irritated Genie, he has a straight black pride movement. We have our movement. Now, it may seem like we're different, and in some cases we are, but we can sure unite for this hit.
Right.
We can come together and say, I don't like my children being molested.
That's
he
right.
said he don't like that either.
Right. Right.
He don't like men being faggots.
Right.
I don't either.
Right.
He said he don't like women being lesbians.
Right.
I don't either.
Right.
What can we do about
right.
that? And we decided to come together and do an event. Do a lecture where we can speak on the atrocities, we can speak on the history, where this culture comes from, right. and then provide solutions to fix it.
Right.
Which is the most important thing on the face of the planet.
That's right.
Because brothers like this don't exist everywhere.
That's right.
This brother's a rare breed.
Yes,
sir. I mean by rare breed, for every poppy, there's a billion more that won't say nothing.
Exactly.
Right. Right.
Because we're taught that they got that phrase, children should be seen and not heard.
Right.
Or don't ask, don't tell. And then when you run and tell your parents because they love that uncle more than they love you,
that's right.
or they love their boyfriend right. more than they love you, you say, I've been molested. No, you wasn't.
Right.
You're lying. And then he shuts up. Stop asking the question, why does it take so long?
Exactly.
Right.
That question needs to get thrown out the water. Yes. It's damn near insensitive
right.
to that brother or sister to ask that question because you can't put a price or you can't put a time frame on when somebody can speak.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
So when they willing to speak and tell their story and you find out that it's true, let them let it all down and then let justice reign.
Right.
Let everybody get tore
right.
down.
Man, I just have to... Our men, especially in the inner city, have always come together out of a need for protection, out of the need to defend themselves against a larger society has always hated and targeted us. They formed the Black Spades. They formed the Zulu Nation. They formed Casanova all over, the Latin Kings. So these are now their gangs, but these are organizations that were formed for us to defend ourselves. Now, I do understand that there have been corrupt individuals in there. Do we just throw the whole organization away? And lastly, this brother still expressed a loyalty. He said if he got help, he would love Bambaataa today. Now, that's amazing to have been a victim of him, but still have a loyalty to that organization. So it's bigger than a man. If he is wrong, he needs to be condemned. But do we throw all of our organizations away? Or can we not just get them recouped?
That's why I called him a superhero. Because I don't know if I'd have been that strong.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I called him the superhero.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that he can say I can forgive him if he gets the help proves just how strong
exactly.
his brother is. Because I don't know if I'm that strong.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when it comes to organizations, you mentioned the different gangs and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
There was a brother, I believe, by the name of Supernova Slime.
Uh-huh.
That's his name.
Yeah.
Now, that brother, he was a higher ranking man in a gang.
Mm-hmm.
And he even said how in that gang they was doing molestation. They was doing homosexual acts. So when you ask, can a organization stand? Any organization should stand as long as it's not corrupt. If you're doing anything that tears down the black household, why should you exist? It should not exist. So we gotta, that's why I said we gotta stop falling in love with the name or falling in love with the organization. We gotta fall in love with their principles.
Right.
We gotta fall in love with their ideologies, right, with their doctrines. And if their doctrines fix the black household, then by all means we should be for it. But if their doctrine destroys the man, destroys the woman, destroys that child, how can we let it exist? It's like they buy a playground, but they raping. Like they said, all that peace, love that Zulu was doing, but then in the background they banging little boys.
Right.
Bring a little girl, so the hell, fuck the peace,
right,
fuck the love, fuck all that movement and soul stuff, fuck all of that. That shit got to be torn to the ground.
Of what the fuck you did, and you ran like a fucking coward and won't step up to the plate and own up to your shit. I even called out and told them, listen, we can come in the public, apologize, even apologize to the other people you hurt, and go get some help together. That's how much love I had for that man. That man was like a father to me. People want to know why, well, you know, how you felt so comfortable. I got answers for y'all. To be around Bam, for one, Bam wasn't the first person to molest me. Bam was like the fifth person to molest me. So when he got to me, I was already broken in. You understand? I was already broken in. That's why I was already confused, fucked up. So in one way, you know, in some ways, Bam was still like a hero to me. I know people gonna say, yo, you know, whatever y'all got to say, whatever questions you have, I can answer. Bottom line to it is, Bam should have stepped up and he should have saved the Zulu Nation and kept everybody from going through the scrutiny. But one thing I did learn from this situation is who the fuck is my family and who ain't. Some of those dudes that's still on the council, that's still sitting there, they're covering up for a pedophile. And that's all I can say. Some of these brothers, you're covering up for a pedophile. Y'all know what he did. And then y'all put out a video saying that, you know, y'all gotta look into it. What the fuck is there to look into? He admitted to it already. What is there to look into? So if you could cover up for a pedophile for a couple of dollars or because of your feelings, then you deserve, y'all deserve to die with him.
Damn right.
Mm. Right.
You deserve to die with him.
That's right. That's real shit.
You got something you wanna ask me?
I have a question. You know, some people say, why so long to come out? Why would you take so long to come out? This is, I know you heard that many times. Why did you take so long to come out?
Well, for one, if anybody out there can answer this question, how do you tell somebody that a man touched you? How do you tell somebody that a man put his mouth on your private part? How do you tell somebody that a man, it's like the thoughts of it, to even speak it out of my mouth? How do you say that? And then when you somebody that got a reputation like me, I'm strong in these streets, and then you gotta have motherfuckers heckling you. You know what it feels like to stand in front of my daughters and they looking at this shit.
Take your time.
Right,
they looking at this shit on the internet. And gotta hear motherfuckers talking about this nigga Planet Rock Bam's mic. Or better yet, y'all left me out there. Y'all threw me out there like an informant. I done bled for y'all niggas. I done went to jail for homicides. Multiple homicides. Not just me. Alibaba molested. Kip went to jail for homicides. Eric in there, right? It's so many of us that went to jail for homicides behind this shit. And most of us been touched by Bam. The majority of Bronx River projects been touched by Bam. Yeah, he did good works, but when you sit back and you analyze this shit, how good was your fucking work? How good was it really?
Exactly.
You created a cesspool.
Yes.
Peace, unity, knowledge, having fun, song, dance, everything to lure everybody in. And when the dark came, in them dark rooms, in the closets, there's a lot of skeletons.
Right.
You done hurt more motherfuckers than you done saved.
Right.
But everybody feels sorry for the pedophile. How?
Can't do it.
Right. How you feel sorry for the pedophile? How y'all crying over Bam like Pepsi? I heard you was boo-hoo crying because Bam had to step down yesterday. But you ain't crying for me. You ain't crying for my kids.
Right.
You ain't crying for my moms that got to listen to this.
Right. Mm.
Yes.
My mom's got to fuck. She got to feel this. She got to feel the rap because this went on with hubby and my mother.
Exactly. Exactly.
But you crying, bitch?
Mm.
Seriously? Muhammad. Fuck it. I'm calling names again. I went through hell when Bronx River opened. Hell. You blame B.O. for fucking up my life. B.O. ain't fucked my life up. You know what happened? You got shot. And when you got shot, I went to war with my whole projects as a baby. Y'all left me for dead. Bronx River ran y'all out the project. Left me for dead. And that's when I had to pick up steel and learn how to defend myself like a man. And that's when I turned into a savage over you, Muhammad, not B.O. Y'all left me, never came back to fight the battle. And the last homicide that I went to jail with was over the same nigga that shot you. But you gonna tell me that you can't clear my name?
Right.
Wow.
And you my brother?
Right.
I don't even have nothing else to say. Right, Poppy, I'm disgusted.
Poppy, if I can briefly ask you, you mentioned your mother and you mentioned your daughter. Now, we all realize that the victim is the first casualty, but then it's our women that have to pick up the pieces. Even Brother Savage said in his relationship, for 17 years, he couldn't hold hands. And if I can recount what you stated before, the intimacy, women were questioning, hey, how come you're not responding? They didn't know you were dealing through crap that you dealt with this man violating you that early. So can you speak to what are the women's role for helping brothers that are trying to heal through this?
You know what? The only thing I can say to the women is take more responsibility as being mothers. Because some of y'all get so caught up on who y'all sleeping with. Whatever. Some women, like my mom's had six kids, but it goes deeper than that. I'm gonna let you in on a family secret. In my mom's family, my mom's grew up with her stepfather was raping her sisters. And they got pissed off when I posted it up on Facebook, but I don't care. It is what it is. You know, so she came from an abusive house and had to break free as a young age. Got with my father, who was a dope fiend. You know, I was already messed up behind my pops not being there, mad at the world, halfway hating my moms. My moms wasn't a bad mom. She was a distracted mom. You know? And at the end of the day, mothers have to talk to their kids. A lot of women out here, the biggest problem with your women is your anger. And y'all take it out on your sons, especially if y'all love the father and he ain't there. The son becomes that enemy. And this is the problem with the women. You know, see, another thing I want to touch on too, when somebody says, mom, dad, or society, he touched me. You do not put that kid on the hot seat. You put that pedophile on the hot seat. Lord Sharif stepped forward, and when he stepped forward, he got put on the hot seat. People picked the wrong timing. When you put people or victims on a hot seat, and everybody else, if I had to do this all over again, I don't know if I could do it all over again because of my kids. You see what I'm saying? So when you put somebody on a hot seat like that, you gotta understand something. You make them children say, I'm not going through that.
Right.
Some of the hecklers on all over the internet, when you read those comments, if a kid had to read that, how the hell do you expect them to come forward? I firmly believe some of y'all dudes are pedophiles and y'all trying to chase them kids back in the hiding. They not going to come forward. And the people need to see that y'all out here, that we out here, we got them. I got you. Believe me, I got you. I got the children.
Knowing what you've been through, and you say you got children in, what do you do to protect your children from what happened to you?
I felt my children. I went to jail. Murder cases, 94. Left my son out here. My son that I left out here. Somehow he got molested. Now to this day, he got titties. He a woman now. Not even in my life. Because somebody molested him. And I never got to catch up to whoever molested him. You know, so the story runs deep. Somewhere at some point, everybody got to take a stand.
Right.
You don't cover up for pedophiles. Pepsi, Ahmed, everybody else that was at that meeting, How the hell you gonna run the head? How you gonna be the head of the Zulu Nation when you still covering up for a pedophile? How?
Exactly.
How? So you mean to tell me if I come through the door with a couple of million, I could fuck a few little kids too? Mm. Is that how it works?
Right.
Somewhere down the line, you know, Zulu Nation got secrets. This is something I take to my grave. But child molestation is not one of them.
I have training in nursing. There was a case in 1964 that happened here called the Genovese effect. Anyone who studies psychology, they know a person who was brutally murdered and tons of witnesses heard it. They saw it, but nobody called. All of these abuses taking place, could this be a situation where people just thinking, oh, someone else is going to report it, someone else is going to take action? And if that still exists among us, isn't that an indictment on us as a community? Because you even asked your first recording. You knew I was in that room. How come you didn't come and take me out of that room? So are we just looking at our kids being brutalized and taken advantage of and not man enough to stand up and defend them? Is that part of what we collectively own because of this tragedy?
You know what? I can't even answer that question. I'm just too emotional. I can't even think straight right now. What I do want to say is, though, once again, I would have took this secret to my grave. Because this is just some shit you don't tell somebody. Like, I got homies, but my wife, my family, like, yo, you never told me this. How the fuck could I? How could you? But I kept hearing.
ISUPK.
Oh, I'm going to tell you, man, if you want to stay plugged in and tuned in, make sure you subscribe to ISUPK on YouTube. A lot of powerful information will be coming out this summer, and you want to stay tuned in. The minute they drop it, it's coming right to you, baby, as soon as you subscribe. So make sure you handle that business and subscribe to ISUPK.
And then you got to have motherfuckers heckling you. You know what it feels like to stand in front of my daughters, and they looking at this shit.
Take your time.
That's right.
They looking at this shit on the internet. And got to hear motherfuckers talking about this nigga Planet Rock Bam's mic. Or better yet, y'all left me out there. Y'all threw me out there like an informant. I done bled for y'all niggas. I done went to jail for homicides. Multiple homicides. Not just me. Alibaba. Molested. Kip went to jail for homicides. Eric in there, right? There's so many of us that went to jail for homicides behind this shit. And most of us been touched by Bam. The majority of Bronx River Project's been touched by Bam. Yeah, he did good works, but when you sit back and you analyze this shit, how good was your fucking work? How good was it really?
Exactly.
You created a cesspool.
Yes.
Peace, unity, knowledge, having fun, song, dance, everything to lure everybody in. And when the dark came, in them dark rooms, in them closets, there's a lot of skeletons.
Right. Yes.
You done hurt more motherfuckers than you done saved.
Right.
I sat back and I watched the video. Broke my heart. that they posted on Facebook. You know, Bam already admitted to this shit. So I don't understand at this point in time why dudes are still sitting up there talking about they gotta look into it. There's nothing else to look into. Everybody that's in that video saying that Bam has stepped down or they all made him sit down was there. They already know what time it is. You see what I'm saying? Bam already had a meeting with me. He apologized. He said he was going to do things for the youth, and he was going to apologize to everybody else. I forgave Bam. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, I want people to understand something. I got a lot of anger towards Bam, but I still love him like a father to me. So I'm not going to slander him, even though he did some fucked up shit. I love that man. I hate what he's going through. I love that man. But what I will say is, I'm heartbroken, man.
Take your time. Take your time.
I'm heartbroken because my brothers know, and I had a conversation with them. I told them, I said, you know what? There's brothers out there in Zulu Nation that don't know me. They don't know how I get down. And for you to leave it like that, and they feel like I love Bam. Everybody feels like Bam is a hero. Somewhat, I felt like he was a hero to me. So for y'all to leave it like that, and some of the new Zulus that don't know me, you see me on the street, and I have to deal with you because you feel like I'm an agent. Y'all left me out there to be a fucking agent. And for me to have to hurt one of them because they love him with some sucker shit. And I had this conversation with one of the brothers, and I told him, like, yo, this is what you're doing. Brother, don't put me involved. How you gonna tell me not to put you involved when you called the meeting? You begged me to take the video down, and I took the video down because y'all wanted to save the Zulu Warriors. I wanted to save the Zulu Warriors. You did good work with the Zulu Warriors. Fed a lot of people. I understand these brothers got love for Bam. I had love for Bam too. What made me lose my respect for Bam at this point in time, after what you did to me, you left the whole Zulu Nation to build a wrath. You know, stories. Whispers. Bam doing this, Bam doing that. Bam got locked up in Brazil. Bam got stabbed. I rushed to the hospital. What happened? Man, somebody tried to rob him, get to the hospital. Saladin, once again, Poppy, get involved in this, you're going to hell. In the pit of my stomach, I already knew what time it is. So, make a long story short, then you come to find out he giving a young man head with his finger in his rectum, and he wakes up and loses it. It stabs Ahmed, he stabs Ahmed, and he stabs Ben. There's over 100 people loaded up with guns at the hospital. Why would you lie about being stabbed if you didn't do nothing to that young boy? Ahmed, why would you lie about it? Don't call your names. Why wouldn't I call your names? Y'all covering up for pedophiles. Why wouldn't I call your name? Why wouldn't I? How the fuck do y'all sleep at night? How? On some real shit, Ahmed? One day you said to me, I don't know if you remember it. Well, I saw B.O. with his dick in Bam's mouth. But I thought you said you ain't never seen that. You don't remember saying that to me? And you said that to me about my hero? I don't know why. Maybe I had some issues. But if you ain't seen nothing, how could you say that about him? Plenty of times I was in that room, you was in the next room. Everybody in the world knew what was going on. If you go to Bronx River or you talk to anybody in the Bronx about Bam and you ask them about the Zulu Nation, they say, he's like Freddy Krueger. We ain't playing with that boy lover. The verdict is in. We gonna stop with the bullshit, with the alleged bullshit. Let's stop it, man. Bam been the boogeyman. We ain't waiting for him to step forward no more. The only thing for you to step forward to do is to come get help. And if you willing to step forward and come get help, I stand beside you still. And don't give a fuck about what nobody got to say. See, another thing I want to put on blast too, with y'all conniving asses, I notice how y'all start trying to move my age up. Forgetting that I was in jail at 18 for murders. Can't change that. Trying to move me up like I was a grown man messing with him. Nah. Y'all tried to have Saladin say that Bee Stinger molested a 4-year-old girl 3 days ago. Tried to have him call in and call Star. Call Star, ask Star about it. Called them on the phone to put those kind of allegations on Beasting. What kind of shit is that? So y'all willing to go that far? To free Bam? For what?
so he could go back to Brazil and get locked up again for playing with another little boy? This is just recent shit. So it's okay for Bam to play with as many little boys as he wants to. Not on my watch. I'd rather die.
Right.
And one thing I will say, I expected to see some of y'all out here. I'm not running. I ain't going nowhere. It is what it is.
What I'd like to first say is we need to give Poppy and all of them a round of applause. Even give his story to face the backlash. I saw his kids. I don't know if y'all friends with him on Facebook. I am. And I saw his two girls. He got two beautiful girls. And to see him to still raise them kids up through the hell that he been through. Remember, it ain't just Bambada that he was a victim. He was a victim to a bunch. And for him to be able to raise a family up, I think is to be commendable.
That's right.
The other thing I think King Simon said and what I've heard other people say is the whole alleged term. I think we're way past that.
Yeah.
We should stop saying alleged. He's a pedophile. And also something that's being said, which I hear all the time, which is a culture. The culture is not just hip-hop. The culture exists from the Roman Catholic Church,
that's
Christianity.
Right.
And hip-hop is no different than the Roman Catholic Church.
That's right.
And that's what we're finding out.
Right.
Because they look at Bambada as if he's the father of hip-hop. And that was built the same way Christianity was built, child molestation.
Right.
And we have to face that reality. And then they mentioned how Bambada, they said Bambada is stepping down now. We have to realize that, and I'll use this analogy. When Mike Brown got killed in St. Louis, right? And then they didn't charge the cop for the crime. And then they investigated the whole Ferguson. And they found out from the governor all the way down to the clerk that it was corrupt. And so the only way to fix that corruption is to do what? To tear the whole thing down.
All the way down.
And start all over.
Yes, sir.
That's the Zulu Nation.
Right.
The Zulu Nation have to be tore all the way down because they damn near like Johnny come late. If Poppy don't say nothing, if Savage don't say nothing, they still molesting little boys.
Right.
Yeah, they still doing it. The only reason they saying something is because the pressure is coming up so bad. The pressure is coming up so much to where they can't hide it. So when KRS-One say, I don't give a fuck what Bambada did. Because he cares about hip-hop so much, I would love what black people have to stop doing it, and what we all get caught up in is idolizing men. And women, for that matter. We turn people into idols. And